Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making white sheet cake. And that just means I'm making a white cake and I'm going to be baking it in a 13 by 9 by 2 baking dish. And that's actually a quarter of a sheet cake, but I'm just calling it sheet cake. I've got a large bowl here, and into that bowl I'm going to be adding some butter. Here we have two sticks, each of them is 1/2 cup, so we have 1 cup of butter that we're putting in our large bowl. And then to that we're adding white granulated sugar, 2 cups. And I'm going to be mixing that together. I'll get to that in just a minute with my mixer. Right here in front of me I have 1 cup of milk and 1 1/2 teaspoons of vanilla extract. And we're going to mix that together and just let it sit for a minute while we're doing some other things. So I'll go ahead and get this mixed up and then we'll continue. Here's what our butter and sugar looks like after it's been beaten on medium speed with an electric mixer. And you just want it to be light and fluffy. Then we're going to move on to our dry ingredients here. I have 3 cups of all-purpose flour. And to that, I'm adding 1 tablespoon of baking powder. And I'm just going to stir that in. And the reason for stirring is just to disperse the baking powder a little bit throughout the flour so that it won't be clumped in one spot in the batter. And that's probably good enough. Now, I have these two sitting to the side of my beaten butter and sugar. And what I want to do is to incorporate both of these into my batter. So I'll be starting with the dry ingredients, the flour and the baking powder. And I'll just put a little bit of that in and I will beat it. And after I've beaten it for a little bit and incorporated it completely, then I'll be pouring some of my milk and vanilla in. And I'll continue to alternate between those, ending with the flour mixture. Here's our batter. After completely adding the dry ingredients and the milk with vanilla, and you'll see that our batter is pretty stiff. It's kind of like dough. What we're going to do to lighten that up is add beaten egg whites. So right here in this bowl, I have 5 egg whites, no yolk. In fact, you will not be able to beat your egg whites if there are any foreign matters in there. You can put some salt in there, that sometimes helps, and maybe a few other things, but you basically don't want any egg yolks in there, so you're very careful when you put these, when you separate these. So we're going to beat this. Here we have our beaten egg whites, and they should be fairly stiff. When I shake them, they do not move, and you can see a little bit of peaks in there. Once you get there, then put all of this in and then fold it into the batter. And that's going to lighten up the batter a lot. So it'll take a few minutes for me to get this folded, but the method is to just go around and then fold over until you get it all incorporated. And it takes a little while to do that because it's a slow motion. And just keep going around the bowl, folding it in, trying not to mash it. We have our egg whites incorporated into the batter, and it looks much more like cake batter now. We're going to put this in our prepared pan. This is a baking dish, actually, or you can use a metal pan if you want to, but this is 13 by 9 by 2. So I'm just going to pour and then smooth it out. This will go to a 350 degree oven, and I always try to bake cakes in the center of the oven unless I have several layers. And with regard to layers here, if you want a 2-layer cake or a 3-layer cake, then you may use round cake pans and just divide up the batter accordingly and watch the baking time, just use a toothpick test to see when it's done, and that would be an alternative to this form. But I think you'll enjoy having one like this because I do a lot that are in layers. So we just smooth this out and then bake it for probably 20 to 25 minutes, but again, I'm not promising anything. I will be checking and I will make sure it's done. And immediately when it's done, it will come out of the oven and go on a cooling rack. Here's our white sheet cake right out of the oven. It's very hot. It took 20 minutes. Now, as far as this video is concerned, it's done because all we're doing is making the cake today. In the next video, I will make an interesting icing, and I promise it will not be chocolate. I've had a lot of chocolate recently, mainly thinking about Valentine's Day. I've had red velvet, and you're probably getting pretty tired of that, and maybe you're getting tired of sweets altogether. After Valentine's Day, we'll try to break that trend. But this will be something totally different, and I think you'll enjoy it for a topping for this cake. So I'm not doing a taste test. I want to keep this intact, and then I will let it cool off, and I'll make a nice frosting that I think you will really enjoy, and I will taste test the cake and the icing at that point.